This is a video review of Fanatec's latest hardware, including the Clubsport Wheel platform, the crown jewel of their wheel line. It has a hub that allows for detachable rims. Here you see the Formula rim, retails for $180. And here you see the BMW GT2 wheel. It retails for $250, and it is basically a race car wheel. This review will also talk about the new Clubsport Pedals, the V2 model. It is improved over the original V1, and we'll get into the details of that later. This retails for $250. The Clubsport Wheel platform is an engineering marvel. It's got two belts inside that basically mimic the feeling of a real car, and it also allows a ton of force to be applied to the wheel, and they give you this nice window to be able to see all of the little details inside. Both of the wheels have 11 buttons and two thumbsticks. The one on the left has full 360-degree movement. The one on the right has a four-way selector, can also be pushed in, and it has a rotary function, which is really convenient for navigating menus. Both of the wheels also have LCD screens with this little tuning button here. It allows you to have full control over all of the internal settings. You can have up to 5 presets, which could be one for each game if you so chose. Sensitivity is the degree of rotation all the way up to 900 degrees. You also have full control over the force feedback from 0 to 100, and all sorts of other settings, including things for linearity and dead zone. There's one in here for ABS, which I really liked. It allowed you to control the motor on the back of the pedals so that you could feel essentially a simulation of brake lockup. All of these were fully customizable on the fly, so while you were playing a game, you could be adjusting how much force feedback you wanted, and it wouldn't affect any of the gameplay. The craftsmanship of this setup was really quite amazing. Both of the wheels had Alcantara leather on the hand grips, and the movements of things like the paddle shifters was so smooth and fluid. The whole thing is really, really well made. Here's the quick release mechanism. It's not really important that you know how it works, just know that it works well. I did have a problem one day getting the BMW wheel to detach from the base. I'll show you what the problem was in a second so you can avoid looking like an idiot. But I wanted to include this footage so you could see how much movement there is in the Rennsport wheel stand V2. Cost about $130, and you probably won't find anything better for the price, but it does bend, flex, sway, whatever you want to call it. You don't really notice it very much while you're racing, but it isn't the most stable platform in the world. And here's the problem I had with the BMW wheel. The end of the spring is sitting proud of the rest of the coil. That was keeping the collar from fully retracting, which was not allowing the little balls inside to let go of the hub. If this ever happens to you, just get a pencil out and push the coil back in line. The Clubsport V2 pedals were really quite amazing. The gas has a full-length travel. It feels just like a real car. The brake has a nice progressive buildup. It gets much, much firmer as you press it farther. And the clutch has one of the most ingenious mechanisms I've ever seen in a pedal setup. I will show you the details in a second, but know that this might be the best part of the package. Here's the clutch mechanism. It feels like a real clutch. There is a weird breakover point where it's engaged and disengaged. It feels so much like a real car, I can't describe it with words. You'd really have to feel it. And it's adjustable, so you can give it different resistance depending on what you prefer. The brake pedal has a reservoir on the back side of it, and the kit comes with 2 different viscosities of oil. The spring can also adjust resistance, but I didn't need to change anything. It felt fine right out of the box. The brake pedal also has this sensitivity dial. It basically adjusts the saturation of the signal. I left it at 10, and it felt really good for me. It felt much like my real car. The brake pedal also has this motor on the back side of it. I'm adjusting it with the steering wheel. You can set it between 1 and 100, and it simulates the effect of brake lockup. It's really quite nice. Overall, the pedals are really quite fantastic. There's tons of adjustability, and the faceplates can even be moved around to make them basically closer together or farther apart. I think these are well worth the money, and they might have actually been my favorite part of the package. The Fanatec hardware that I tested is compatible with the PC and PlayStation 3. Here you can see me playing a PC racing game called R-Factor 2. This game is currently in a beta state. It should be out later this year, but it felt fantastic on the Fanatec hardware. The force feedback really was quite amazing. The saturation from center all the way to the far extent of its rotation felt great. It was easy to catch slides. The pedals really did a good job of giving me feedback for if I was locking up a tire. One thing I should point out is that R-Factor currently has a little bit of a problem with Logitech steering wheels. If you go on the rumble strips or off track into the grass, there's quite a drastic rattle. Feels like the thing is kind of shaking itself apart on the inside. The guys that make this game are working on addressing that for the Logitech hardware, but I had no such issues with the Fanatec stuff. But again, overall, our Factor 2 I think has the best force feedback in sim racing, and with this hardware, it felt fantastic. I wish I could say as many nice things about Project Cars. This game is currently in development. It's made by the people that made Shift. I don't care for the handling or the physics in this game. The force feedback comes through the wheel fine, but I think they have a long way to go towards getting to the realism of games like R-Factor 2. The handling just feels mildly arcadey when you turn in for a corner. It almost feels like it's following a pre-scripted line. Again, I don't think this is Fanatec's problem. I think this is something that the game is unfortunately plagued by, and I'm hoping that before it comes out, they will be able to address the problems. Overall, with the wheel though, saturation felt fine. I'd make some mild adjustments to get all of the resistance feeling how I thought it should. But if this game is one of the ones that you play a lot, I don't think you're going to feel a wild improvement going to Fanatec hardware. I also tried Richard Burns Rally, which has a little Logitech logo up in the left corner. It felt fine on the Fanatec wheel, so no problems there. As I mentioned earlier, this Fanatec hardware works for PS3, so here I am playing Gran Turismo 5. The wheel felt great here as well. It's easy to catch slides, and the only criticism I really have is that the button layout on the steering wheel does not match any kind of PlayStation controller, so it can be a little confusing when you're trying to navigate menus. I also played Dirt 3 on the PS3. It's a Codemasters game, which means it's not all that realistic. The handling felt fine. It wasn't really an improvement over my current Logitech steering wheel. But again, any limitations of the force feedback are really Codemasters' problem, not Fanatec's. I also tried F1 2011 on the PS3. This was really quite fun to put on the Formula wheel and pretend that I was an F1 driver. I enjoyed having all of the buttons nearby. It was nice to be able to push one for curves and another for DRS. The force feedback was really quite intense. I actually had to turn it down to about 60% because my forearms were getting tired. This game is great with the Fanatec wheel. I did have one small problem putting this whole thing together. The bolts on this side of the base screwed in fine. You can see the threads are still fully intact and everything went A-OK. On the other side, however, the holes were fractionally too small. I ended up having to get up my drill and a 7/32 bit to open them up a little bit, and as you can see, the threads got a little bit mangled even with the enlarged hole. So I'm hoping that this is just a pre-production flaw and that anybody that buys this wheel will not experience the same thing I did. All in all, I thought this wheel was fantastic. Here I am playing Netcar Pro. I've never had so much fun playing that game. The steering wheel just felt so alive and realistic. The movement you see there in the Rennsport wheel stand isn't noticeable when you're actually playing, and in general, I think this wheel is really quite amazing. Is it worth the money? That's a different question altogether. Let's put this in perspective. If you were going to go buy a basic Logitech steering wheel, like the Driving Force GT, that would set you back about $100. The next step up is the Logitech G27 for $220. Going from a basic wheel to something quite nice increases the price 2.2x. That might be quite a hard pill to swallow for some people, but I think you get what you pay for with the G27. It feels great, the pedals are nice, the whole experience is really quite enjoyable. If you take the CSW base and add the cheapest rim, the Formula rim, for $180, plus the pedal set that I reviewed, that's $880. So you're going from $220 to $880, an increase of 4x. So it's not quite the same monetary jump as going from a basic wheel to the G27, significantly higher. The question is, do you get 4 times the enjoyment? And I'm inclined to say you don't. I really enjoyed using the Fanatec hardware. The customization was great, and I enjoyed the force feedback that it gave me. Everything was buttery smooth, and it felt really professional. I enjoyed being able to go into all the menus and adjust settings, but I just can't imagine spending $880 out of my pocket for something like this. And that doesn't even include something like the Rennsport stand or a playseat to mount it on. But then again, if you've made it to this part of the review, you might just be one of those crazy people who wants to invest in some quality hardware. And if that's what you're looking for, I've got to recommend this Fanatec setup, and I hope this review was helpful.